In this tutorial, we will create this assembly. This tutorial will be of two parts. In first tutorial, we will create these parts, and in second tutorial, we will create this assembly. I request you to watch this complete tutorial from start to finish to understand part modeling and assembly concept in NX perfectly. If you are interested in more such type of videos, then please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start this tutorial by creating this first part. To create this part, click here on New. Then select millimeter as units. And click here on Model. And as this part is top, therefore we will name it as top. So we will name it as top. Then we will change folder. For that, click here. And I will choose this default. Click on OK. Click on OK. Then click here on Extrude. Click on Sketch section. Click on OK. At first, we will create this rectangle of 150 by 60 size. Then we will create these cuts of 20 by 10 size. Click here on Home. Click on Rectangle. Then click here on From Center. Then select this sketch origin as center point. Click on Existing Point, Sketch Origin. Take your cursor away. Ensure that this orange line is straight. Then specify width of 150, enter. Height of 60, enter. Angle of 0, and enter. So here this rectangle is ready. Then to create this cut of 20 by 10 size, and it is at the midpoint of this vertical line. So rectangle command is still active. Click here on this midpoint. Take your cursor on the upper side. Specify width of 20. Enter. And height will also be 20. Enter. Enter. Then zoom there. Then trim unwanted part. For that, click here on Quick Trim. And remove unwanted objects. Zoom minus. Then we want same shape on opposite side. For that, we will mirror it. Click on Close. Click here on this arrow. Click on Mirror Curve. Then actually I want to select individual objects. Therefore click here and select single curve. And click here on these lines. Then click here on select center line. And click on this Y axis. Select this sketch vertical axis. Click on OK. Then click on Quick Trim and remove this object. Then click on Close. Now here sketch contains over constraint geometry. So four corners are at 90 degree and here 0 degree is also shown in red color. So we don't want this 0 degree. So just select it and delete it. Click on OK. So here now sketch is fully constrained. Then right click. Click on Finish Sketch. Then thickness of object is 10. So here is also 10. Click on OK. Then we will have to create this chamfer, where height of chamfer will be 10 and angle is 75 degree from this horizontal line. And if I specify angle from this vertical line, then this vertical line is at 90 degree minus this 75, that means this will be 15 degree. Click on chamfer. click on this line. Then I want this distance obtained on other side. So click here on reverse direction. And angle of 15 is correct. Click on OK. So here the chamfer is created perfectly. Then I want same chamfer on the opposite side. For that I will mirror the chamfer. For mirror, click here on more and click on mirror feature. Then select the chamfer, click on select plane and click here on this exit plane. Click on exit plane, click on OK. So here the chamfer is created on other side also. So this object is ready. Click on save and close this part. Then click on new. Again millimeter model. Now next part is this one. Name of this part is leg. So we will name it as leg. OK. Then again click on extrude. Click on sketch section. Click on OK. Click on home. In this part, at first we will create this shape. Then we will mirror it on opposite side. So we will create only half shape. So here this line will be of 10 size. This is also of 10 size. And this is of 20. Then inclined line and horizontal line. And angle is 75 degree. Click here on this sketch origin. Click on existing point, sketch origin. Take your cursor on this side. Ensure that line is horizontal. Length is 10. Enter, enter. Take your cursor below. Again 10. Enter, enter. Take your cursor on this side. Then 20. Enter, enter. Then press shift. Press middle mouse button and pan it on this side. Take your cursor on this side, click, take it here, click, then right click and cancel. Then gap between these two lines is 100 and this is 75 degree. Click here on rapid dimension. Click on this line, take your cursor on this side, click. Specify height of 100, enter. Then select this line, take your cursor inside, click. Specify angle of 75, enter. Click on close. Then we want this line align with this y axis. So for that, click on this y axis. Click on this point. Then click here on this point on curve. So they will get aligned perfectly. Then we want to mirror it on opposite side. For that click here on this arrow. Click on mirror curve. Now we want to mirror this complete shape. So click here. Click on connected curves. Then select one line. It will select complete curve. Then click on select center line. And click on this y axis. Sketch vertical axis. Click on OK. So here this shape is ready. Zoom it. Then this cut of 10 by 20 size and location is 60. Click on profile. Click on this line. Take your cursor on this side. Specify length of 20. Enter, enter. Take your cursor on this side, then 10, enter, enter. Then take your cursor on this side and click. Right click, cancel. Then click on rapid dimension. Click on this line, click. Then 60, enter. Then click on quick trim and remove unwanted objects. Click on close. Now here also it got cut. But that will not be a problem we will solve this problem. So before that, we will create this cut again of 20 by 10 at 20 height. Click on profile. Click on this curve. Take your cursor on this side, 20, enter, enter. Again on this side, 10, enter, enter. Take your cursor outside, click, right click, cancel. Then double click, height is 20, enter, close. Then trim unwanted portion, again click on quick trim. Click on this line, then escape. Click on quick extend. Click on this line. So here it got connected perfectly. Then this sketch is also ready. Press escape. So sketch is fully constrained. Right click, finish sketch. You can also use Ctrl Q as a shortcut. Then thickness of 10 is correct. Click on OK. Then to give color to this part, click here. Click on solid body. Select this body. Click on edit display. Then click here and select your desired color. Click on OK. Click on OK. So this part is also ready. Click on save. Close this part. Then again click on new. Then next part is step. So we will name it as step. Click on OK. Click on extrude. Click on sketch section. Click on OK. In this part, we will create this rectangle of 170 by 50 size. Click on home. Click on rectangle. Then select this from center. Click on sketch origin. Click on existing point sketch origin. Take your cursor away. 170, enter, 50, enter, enter. Then there is one more rectangle here. So click here. We want this rectangle with different method. So click here on by 2 points. Then here size is 10 by 30 and location is 10. So specify here 10. Enter 30, enter and click. Then zoom there, right click, cancel, double click, 10, enter, close. Then trim this, click on quick trim, then click here and one more time click here because there were two lines. Click on close. Then we want same on the opposite side. So we will again mirror it. Click here. Click on mirror curve. Then click here. Click on single curve. And select these curves. Click on select center line. Click on this Y axis. Click on OK. Then quick trim. Click. Close, right click. Okay, before that, sketch contains or constraint geometry, so click and delete. Okay, right click, finish sketch. Thickness of 10 is correct. Okay, then click here, solid body, click. Click on edit display, click here, suppose I will choose this color, OK, then save and close. I will change color of this part also, just click on it, click, solid body, click, edit display, click. And suppose I will choose this one. OK. Then save. close. So all the three parts are ready. So that's all for now. In the next tutorial, we will create this assembly. So thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. And we will again meet in next tutorial.